Hello, I'm Ivan. Some people ask me how to install and configure the inductive probe on my adapted Voron Afterburner printhead for CR-10 and tender type of printers. Well, the process is very similar to what you'll find in the official Voron resources, but here is a short video guide for choosing, installing and configuring automatic bed leveling with the Afterburner. Here you see my configuration, a 9-point mesh probing with 3 measurements per point. Myself, I use SKR version 1.3 board and Klipper firmware, but the setup should be similar for another board or if you're using the Marlin firmware. The official Afterburner probe is PLN08, normally closed inductive sensor. This is fine for just auto bed leveling with separate Z end stop. However, I am using the probe also as an end stop and I needed a more precise device. With help from the Voron Discord community, I bought an Omron sensor with 5mm sensing distance, also normally closed. It gives better results and less deviations related to the bed temperature. Check the video description or the Thingiverse project page for more information. This probe has the same dimensions and the mounting is very easy. The inductive probe is powered by 12 or 24 volts, depending on your printer PCU. On the signal wire, you will have also this voltage. Most boards, though, support up to 5 volts on their end stop pins, and higher voltages may cause damage. In order to limit the voltage on the signal wire, we'll be using a Schottky diode. It will limit the voltage to 0.4 volts. The type of diode is BAT85 and you can solder it in line on the signal wire. I soldered mine close to the connector to the board. I used the Z-Max connector on the board to connect the ground and the signal wire of the probe. The power wire will be connected directly at the PCU on a 12 volts output. Here you see my Klipper configuration. Under the stepper Z configuration, I defined that the probe will be used as an end stop. In case you have banded areas on your bed, you can define a negative position minimum, so the hot end can go below zero. Then in the probe definitions, the X and the Y offsets are given by the Voron documentation and you have to define the Z offset only. This is the distance between the bed and the nozzle when the probe triggers. In my case, it is 2.2 mm. I also use 3 samples per probing to be more accurate. That's it. Like in Marlin, I prefer to use safe Z homing in the center of the build plate. Then you must define the minimum and maximum points for the mesh. In my case, the max point is at X250 and Y250 mm, because I use different build surfaces and some of them are smaller than the back. Finally, you can configure a G-code macro for the G29 command. In my case, it includes the G28, which is homing of X, Y and Z, and the batmesh calibrate command. So in your start code in Simplify 3D or in Cura, you don't need to write the G28 command as it's already included in the G29. You can test the probe accuracy by issuing a probe accuracy command in the Octoprint terminal. This makes 10 consecutive tests of the probe and you can see the results in the terminal. It is important to have deviation smaller than 0.003. In my case, I have 0 deviation, which is perfect. That's it, we are ready to print. The Autobat leveling is working as expected and performs 9 point mesh with 3 samples per point that give more precise average measurement. While admiring the perfect first layer laid down by the Afterburner, please consider subscribing to my channel. It will make my printer happy.